Microdiscectomy is a minimally invasive surgical procedure to remove the fragment of the herniated lumbar disc to relieve lower back pain. The human spinal cord, a part of the central nervous system, is a tissue structure enclosed within the vertebral column. Between each vertebra is a disc of fibrous cartilage called annulus fibrosus that surrounds a gelatinous core called nucleus pulposus. These disc materials provide cushion and act as a shock absorber for easy and non-frictional movement of spinal bones. Due to some reasons, if the intervertebral disc rupture, for instance, the lumbar disc rupture, the disc material release into the outer space and compress the nearby nerves. The ruptured disc is called herniated lumbar disc and the condition is called disc herniation. Common causes of disc herniation include aging, obesity, occupation and driving. 1. Aging. With the age, our intervertebral discs degenerate naturally because ligaments that hold the discs in place become weaker. As a result, older people are more prone to disc herniation with even a minor twist. 2. Obesity. Heavy weight puts extra pressure on the intervertebral discs of an obese person so that disc herniation can occur more quickly. 3. Occupation. Herniated disc condition is also common in people with physically demanding jobs because of regular weightlifting that may damage their intervertebral discs and result in disc herniation. 4. Driving. Frequent driving may also result in disc herniation because being seated for a long period with constant vibration from the motor vehicle engine can damage intervertebral discs. How is microdiscectomy performed? A step-by-step procedure is as follows. A patient is laid down on their stomach, fully anesthetized, breathed through a breathing tube, and gets nutrients intravenously. Surgeon makes a small incision in the skin and uses special retractors to reach the herniated disc area without damaging the nearby tissues and muscles. X-rays help the surgeon to identify the herniated disc in an operating microscope to magnify and visualize the injured spine area. Surgeon removes a small portion of superior lamina to fully visualize and remove the herniated disc using small dental-type instruments. Once the surgeon removes all parts of the protruding disc and ensures that nerve and muscles are not damaged, he sutures the deep fascial and subcutaneous layers and uses special surgical glue to close the wound without bandage. After successful surgery, most patients are discharged the same day after a few hours of hospital stay.